Is that Diet Coke and Mentos?
Yep.
Dude, I know what we can do with that.
Eat them.
No, man, we can make a soda fountain.
Cool.
Dude, how did that happen?
I don't know, man.
Just happens, I guess.
Maybe we should check the library.
Dang, that library was crowded.
Hey, this website says that the carbon dioxide bubbles in the soda are what caused the reaction.
Isn't that what makes the soda fizzy?
Well, this website says the aspartame, caffeine, and potassium benzoate also are involved in the reaction.
What are those chemicals? Aspartame is the fake charger that makes it a diet soda.
Caffeine is the chemical in soda that makes you hyper and stay up at night.
Isn't that the same stuff that's in coffee?
Potassium benzoate is the preservative that keeps the soda tasting fresh.
I wonder if there's anything in Mentos that helps the reaction.
This website says the gelatin and gum arabic are the parts of the Mentos that react.
Gelatin is no longer in the Mentos.
What are these things called, nucleation sites?
They're small pits in the candy that help bubbles form. Did you guys know that Mythbusters did an episode on soda and Mentos?
I bet it's on Netflix. Let's watch it.
The scientific method refers to a body of techniques for investigating phenomena, acquiring new knowledge, or correcting and integrating previous knowledge. To be termed scientific, a method of inquiry must be based on gathering observable, empirical, and measurable evidence subject to specific principles of reasoning. A scientific method consists of the collection of data through observation and experimentation, and the formulation and testing of hypotheses.
Whoa, wait a minute. Do we really need to learn this stuff?
Yeah.
Does it make any sense?
We saw a soda fountain yesterday. Can we learn about stuff like that?
Well, what do you know about it?
Well, we did some research and found out a lot.
Yeah, but we still have some questions.
So, you made an observation. You did some research. And now you have questions. Sounds like you are learning the scientific methods. What are the next steps?
We need to design an experiment to answer our questions.
Then we need to come up with a hypothesis.
Then all we need to do is experiment and analyze the results.
Don't forget the conclusion.
Well, let's get started.
My question is, how is alternating the Mentos affect the height of the reaction? My hypothesis. Because I am testing four variations of the Mentos, I have hypothesis for each one. Hypothesis 1. Mentos cut in half should have more surface area. I think it will have more reaction because there is more surface area. Hypothesis 2. Mentos crushed have a lot more surface area. I think it will have a lot more of a reaction because of how much surface area is exposed to the Diet Coke. Hypothesis 3. Mentos without the outer layer don't have any more nucleation sites. I think it will have less of a reaction because there are no nucleation sites. Hypothesis 4. Mentos without the outer layer, but then layered with salt. Now there are nucleation sites on the Mentos. I think there will be more of a reaction because there are nucleation sites on the Mentos. My procedure. I took 5 Diet Coke bottles and put 5 Mentos in each individual bottle. For each procedure, I alternated these Mentos in different ways. The first way was control, which was plain Mentos. The second, I cut in half, and the third, I crushed into pieces. The fourth, I took the outer layer off by soaking the Mentos in water. And the fifth one, I also took the outer layer off and coated them with salt. Conclusion. Mentos cut in half did react more than the control because there is more surface area. There is more of a reaction. Crushed Mentos did not react more than the control. My hypothesis was wrong. I think the little pieces that were crushed Mentos were shot out of the bottle, which created less of a reaction. Mentos without outer covering had less reaction than control because the nucleation sites were removed. Mentos with salt did react more than the Mentos without the outer layer, but not more than the control. So the salt must not have provided as much nucleation sites as we thought.
What I was trying to figure out on my experiment was how the flavor of Mentos affects the Coke and Mentos reaction. The 5 flavors I used were cinnamon, mint, strawberry, fruit mix, and a green apple. My hypothesis of them would be was that cinnamon would do the best because it's kind of hot and spicy, and then mint would do the second best because it's supposedly the best for the whole Coke and Mentos reaction. And then I guessed green apple because of the whole wax coating thing covering up the nucleation sites. And then the last one would be strawberry and fruit mix because I think they do about the same.
Thank you. fermentations were the cold, pretty much. At first, we tested my experiment outside. That day was really cold, so it really affected my results. So then we redid my experiment inside, and we found out the flavors did not have a consistent result. But for the trial we did, first, the highest reaction would have been strawberry, and then second was green apple, then the fruit mix, then mint, and then cinnamon, which was, in the end, was exactly the opposite of my hypothesis. If I was going to do this again, I'd do more tests on each flavor.
My hypothesis was, I thought that the smaller the bottles, with the more Mentos, it would create a bigger reaction. I found out that my hypothesis was wrong, and in fact, the bigger the bottle, the bigger the reaction. I also found out that about 70% of the soda was lost from each of the bottles during the reactions.
The question I experimented with was, does the number of Mentos dropped in the bottle affect the height of the fountain? My hypothesis was that the bottle with 10 Mentos in it will react the best because more Mentos means more nucleation pits and surface area. For the procedure, I took 4 bottles of Diet Coke and 26 Mentos and put 3 in the first bottle, 5 in the second, 8 in the third, and 10 in the last. We measured the height of the reactions and the volume of soda still in the bottle.
My results were that the first trial with 3 Mentos went 170 centimeters, and the second trial with 5 Mentos went 155 centimeters, and my third with 8 went 180 centimeters. Due to technical difficulties, my last trial with 10 Mentos wasn't recorded. This reaction went more than a meter and a half above the meter and a half measuring board we used. This proved my hypothesis correct that the more Mentos used, the higher the reaction. My experiment could have been better if I used a wider range of numbers of Mentos and if it was done outside where there was no ceiling to limit the height of the reaction.
Child now, 'cause every time I see your bubbly face, I get the tingles in a silly place. It starts in my toes and I crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now, just take your time. Wherever you go, the rain is falling on my window pane. We are hiding in a safer place, undercover, staying safe and warm. You give me feelings that I adore. They start in my toes, make me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now, just take your time. Wherever you go, what am I gonna say? Make me feel this way. I just and it's starts in my toes, makes me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now, just take your time wherever you go. For a while now, you tuck me in just like a child now. 'Cause every time you hold me in your arms, I'm comfortable enough to feel your warmth. It starts in my soul and I lose all control. When you kiss my nose, the feeling shows. 'Cause you make me smile, baby, just take your time now, holding me tight. For a while.